I'm Brooke Lee, and this is Modern Wahine Hawaii. Welcome, everybody, to Modern Wahine Hawaii. We're here at the beautiful Hawaii Theater, and I'm with Sarah Richards, who I don't even know how to explain how important you are to this theater, so we're just going to dive right into it. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
I'm excited to be here because, for a lot of reasons, every chance I can get to come to the Hawaii Theater, I say, yes, can I please, because I'm such a big fan. But with you and your history with the theater, you really were part of a very integral team to bring this theater literally back to life, because in my formative days growing up, the theater wasn't up and operational. You couldn't come here, you couldn't see the theater, you couldn't be a part of the magic that is happening here. And then a magical group of people, including yourself, decided she needs to come back and she needs to be in her perfect place of honor here in Chinatown. Do you want to kind of talk about how that all came about?
Well, we started first with the desire to restore the theater and to also restore it in a historic way.
Right.
And we weren't going to give up. We knew we could get the job done.
Right.
And so with a group of very wonderful directors, we kept going.
Yes.
And we raised $34 million in capital funds for the theater, both state and private.
And you had to bring it back. I mean, it was shuttered.
Oh, it was terrible.
Yeah.
It was terrible. The roof was falling in, and it was, and there were rats in here.
Right.
It was in bad shape.
Yeah.
It was very bad shape.
And did at any point people just tell you guys, it's just, what are you guys doing?
Oh, what are you doing? A lot of people did. And also they said, why in the middle of Chinatown? Why would you do this? And so you had to sort of show them that it was possible.
And then in 96, when it came back to her full glory,
yes,
and people walked in here, I bet they changed their tune.
It was a wow. Oh, that they changed their tune entirely.
I'm sure they did. Right. Because, you know, it's the centennial celebration. I mean, that is a very important factor. 100 years of theater in Hawaii is a big deal. The fact that this girl has been standing for 100 years and is now back at full force and being able to be a part of the arts community locally, bringing in great acts. And the fact that you had a fingerprint in the middle of all of that is an amazing thing.
It was an honor to be involved. It was a labor of love.
Absolutely.
It was a labor, all right. But it was, we had wonderful people to help us who never gave up the fact that it was going to come to fruition.
Right.
We also wanted to make sure that we did it in the style that was historic.
Yes, I mean, because that sort of is, a lot of people say whenever you redo things or just tear it down and build something brand new, you know, like reinvent whatever. But there's something about the history. I mean, especially in the centennial year this year, when people come in here, when they had the gala that they had here, the fact that people could say that we were sitting in the seats and watching in the same footprint that 100 years ago, the ali'i and the people of the times back then were doing.
Right.
That's an important sort of moment to be able to capture.
The show that they had for the opening of the 100-year anniversary, they had Hawaii theater through the decades.
Right.
So we started with movie theaters and started with a vaudeville theater.
Nice.
And went all the way through.
It's amazing. I mean, to be able to have that much history on a little island in the middle of the ocean, you know, and to be able to preserve that. Is monumental. But so, just to get a little nosy, I heard through the grapevine that you were kind of a performer back in the day.
Well, I went to music school at the College Conservatory of Music, and I did sing. I sang also in the opera at DePauw University, my college. Yes, I did sing.
And what brought you to the aina? What brought you to Hawaii?
What brought me to Hawaii was actually the Kamehameha schools, because they wanted me to teach English. Nobody wanted to take English at Kamehameha school. So I taught swimming. But that was just for the summer.
Right.
So I came first in 1970, and I as the Dean of Students at Chaminade University.
And so, you know, because of your background in arts, I would assume that you just sort of had an affinity for
absolutely,
it.
Absolutely, absolutely.
All these years, you may not have, you know, pursued it professionally, but it was right. in your heart, close to your heart. Right. So you were involved in the arts community here, and that led you to Hawaii
yes.
Theater? Or how did you guys meet up, you and Hawaii Theater?
I was the director of the State Foundation on Culture and the Arts.
Okay.
And so from there, I came to the Hawaii Theater.
Yeah.
And I was, but of course, everybody thought, oh, the Hawaii Theater is nothing. It's going
right.
to fall down.
It's done. It's done.
It was done.
Yeah.
So I guess that we had the vision that it was going to happen, but we had to put the time and effort to make it happen.
And how long would you say?
Probably about, 10 years anyway.
10 years
yeah.
of just knocking down doors and dragging
yes,
people,
yes.
kicking
yeah,
and screaming
right.
to see a vision
right.
that was not.
But pretty soon they got the idea.
Right. Well, you know, I can't thank you enough, literally, because, I mean, it's just such a monumental achievement. The fact that if people knew what this place, what
yes.
where you started from,
right.
how far you had to bring her back
right.
from. I mean, just the faith alone.
Right.
And the fact that, you know, now it's a thriving industry that people are able to come here, community can come here, big acts can come here, everyone has a chance to be on this beautiful stage. It's really sort of a privilege.
Well, I'm very proud of the what we have been able to achieve.
Yeah.
I am very proud. I also, we want to thank all the people
yes.
that helped us, a wonderful board of directors and the community. But I'm proud of the fact it's here, and I'm proud of the fact it's a historic building, and it's been a wonderful asset to the community.
It truly, truly has, and may she sail on for another 100 more.
Yes. I mean,
well, thank you so much for coming on the show.
Oh, you're very
and
welcome.
And for everything that you've done.
Thank you. Thank you.
Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Modern Wahine Hawaii here on the beautiful stage here at Hawaii Theater. I'm with Gregory Dunn, who I like to say is the heart and soul of the operation here, really.
Too kind.
But, you know, other people call you president and CEO.
That's the title.
That's the title. But it comes with so much more. So much more. So let's talk a little bit about the nuts and bolts of what it takes to keep her ticking. Because
oh my goodness sakes, how much time do we have?
Right,
we only have a few minutes.
Oh, right,
wow. I mean, it's like a 100-year-old building.
Yes.
So with
she looked good for 100 though.
Looks
let's
amazing.
Be honest.
Amazing. Thanks to Sarah and all of the money she raised and the community that came together to save the theater.
Right.
So it could reopen in 1996. Amazing. But we still have to maintain it for future generations. So you're talking about monthly electricity bills over $20,000, even with solar on the roof.
Right.
Our insurance premiums just to insure the facility, close to $25,000 a month.
A month.
A month. So these kind of big numbers really stack up.
Right.
And that's part of the reason why we have such a diverse show schedule that we do, bringing in different shows that are going to generate enough revenue to keep the facility going
yes.
so that we can have it for future generations.
And just to be clear with Hawaiʻi, one of the most diverse programming really in the state. I mean, you guys just really sort of cover all the bases. You don't stay just in one lane. You're in the arts locally. You support Hawaiian music, yes.
Big time.
Big time. You also bring in a lot of major acts.
Huge, huge mainland acts, big touring
huge.
Shows. Ronnie Chang,
right.
Tom Segura.
Mm-hmm.
We've just had Jefferson Starship and Blue Oyster Cult. In the coming months, you'll see acts like Bernadette Peters and Judy Collins coming here, as well as we're bringing an off-Broadway production of The Potted Potter. So
right.
we have all these amazing shows, but around it, we still keep to our local roots, and we
yes.
support the Miss Chinatown pageant. We support Sacred Hearts. We support local schools with the Punch Bowl Music Festival and bringing the kids in. We have our theater education program in partnership
right.
with the Pacific Academy of Performing Arts, and so we'll have the musicals on stage. But we have the commercial things dropped in around it so that we can afford to keep the theater open for everybody.
And it's everybody's theater.
Yep.
That's what's important.
Exactly. We go the gamut from the Hawaii Symphony Orchestra, who's the company in residence at the theater. Mm-hmm. So we have 13 symphony shows a year. The opera's going to be here. But we have Hawaiian music. So Makaha Sons with their Christmas special come back here every year.
Right. I mean, so let's talk about how people can get involved and be a part of, you know, the legacy here, because like we said, the numbers show it all. But, you know, some people come and they drop in and they drop out. But there are programs in place that can, you know, make them a permanent part of the ohana here, right?
We have some really unique opportunities for people. For something that fits every budget, from membership at starting at $45 a year to monthly ability for people to sign up for higher levels of giving. If they want to give every month, we can do automatic draft, so you can become a producer or executive producer level member and get backstage access and special perks. We also have our Corinthian Society, which are people that have remembered the Hawaii Theater in their will. Which helps us to then build our endowment, mm-hmm. so that we can have money to care for the theater into the future. And we also have naming opportunities. People can buy a chair and have a name plaque put on it, or they can sponsor one of the areas of the theater and have a component named after them. Most recently, we received a very large gift from Carolyn Barry Wilson, and she's chosen to have our theater pipe organ named after her, the Carolyn Barry Wilson Theater Pipe Organ.
Nice. So when you're, you know, looking out into the audience, because you're here on every show, and the shows go on, what are you seeing in the faces? Because, I mean, not to harp on, you know, the past, but we were all in lockdown, but the theater was still running. I mean, in its own special way, you guys found a way with Hanale and Haka Entertainment to keep the lights on, even though it was a struggle, let's be honest.
Tremendous struggle.
Yeah.
We went on faith and did live streaming of programming. We put dozens of Hawaiian artists, musicians and performers that work on stage so they could still keep connecting with their audiences. And then the crew that were here were able to work because we were doing live streaming content. And now that we're back to live performances, those numbers are times a factor of 10, the number of people that we're able to employ and then bring economic vitality to the Chinatown community, mm-hmm. so that the restaurants and bars and shops have more foot traffic, help rebound from COVID. When I get on stage to welcome people to the Hawaii Theater Center Presents shows, it's amazing to see the smiles on people's faces. I can't see everyone because of the theater lights, but the people in the front couple of rows, and they're excited, they're thrilled to be back in the community again. And that's the real thing that Hawaii Theater is built around, is the community.
Right.
We look at what segments of the community can we provide entertainment opportunities for. We bring in the shows for them to come and see and enjoy, and then share the experience with their family and friends when they come to the theater.
I mean,
that's what it's about.
There's a lot of opportunity here in Hawaii. Arts here is a wonderful thing, but there's something special about the camaraderie here and just the vibe. And you just feel like you're a part of history, but you're also part of something new, which, you know, you can't really get here in the islands in too many places. So thank you so much for all that you do for us here in the islands, for bringing in the wonderful acts. That's the other thing I love about you, is like whenever we're doing shows with Makasas and the Leo, what have you, you're always backstage going, who you guys want to see? Who's in your head? You know, because you're always out there sort of searching, for the big acts, but maybe some of the other acts that, you know, you're like, maybe there's a niche here. Maybe there's something people want to see. Mm-hmm. And that's that sort of interactiveness that really is exciting to me. So thanks for all
you do,
Gregory.
Thank you for all you do, Miss Universe.
Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Modern Wahine Hawaii here at the beautiful Hawaii Theater. I'm with Cathy Lee, who is the chairman of the Centennial Committee for the Hawaii Theater Centennial Celebration, and you're on the board of directors.
Yes.
Busy lady. How are you?
I'm doing good. Thanks, Brooke.
Thanks for coming on the show.
Absolutely.
And welcoming us into your guys' world here. Yeah, I've been busy. But first we have to start, because everybody's always in the LA. People want to know all of the backgrounds of everybody and everything. We're Pearl City girls.
Yes, we are.
Born and raised. And you do a lot of charity work. I mean, you do a lot here with the theater, but tell everybody about, you know, some of the other stuff that you do.
I'm someone who has always believed in giving back. Growing up in Pearl City, my parents and, you know, the five of us, it was a struggle. And so there was no concept of giving back or charity when you can barely, you know, pay the bills. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Mm. And so once, you know, I started adulting and, you know, having a good professional life, it was important to me to give back. And I think that it's you get back when you give back. Right. And so that's what I believe in.
And so your entry, I guess, into the arts community started through your family, right? Through your daughter? Is that how it worked?
Well, my daughter was my inspiration and actually how I came here to the Hawaii Theater. Mm-hmm. So when my daughter Nikki was in elementary and middle school, she was very much into performing arts, loved to be on stage. And the Hawaii Theater reached out to me and asked me to join the board. And so I said yes, and I've been here ever since, and I'm very proud of it.
And like, we don't need to put numbers on it, but like, you've been with the board a while, and you guys have really transformed. I mean, there has been some hurdles, but you know, gearing up for this 100th, like, let's just clear up any sort of misconceptions, because it's the 100th year, and she turned 100 this year. She looked good.
She looked good
for 100.
Yes.
But you know, the ceremonies and all of the I guess different events are going to go on for a whole calendar year. It's not going to end at midnight on the 31st of December 2022. You guys are carrying this for a whole year, right? So into the next year, you guys are planning all kinds of fabulous events. But tell everybody a little bit about this one fabulous event that you helped sort of shepherd for the celebration.
Sure. I think that we all believed on the board that it was important to celebrate in a one-of-a-kind way. After all, 100 years is a big deal. And so we didn't want to just host any kind of a gala. It had to be meaningful.
Right.
And so first off, we started out with a concert right here in the seats, sitting in the same place that people did 100 years ago. Mm-hmm. And then when the show was over and people stepped outside, we closed off Bethel Street.
Of course.
And we had about 300 guests, and it was just magical. Food and music, and it was just a wonderful way to see our marquee lights, mm-hmm. and to know that we have survived 100 years, especially during the pandemic.
I know.
Like,
that was
so
rough.
Many arts institutions, it's been difficult, but I think it was just a wonderful way to let people know we're here, we're still here, mm-hmm. and we still need your support.
Right. I mean, and it was a wonderful turnout. I mean, yes. People just came out. The 100 years of anything really is an accomplishment, but in the arts, for sure. I mean, we're roughly the same age. I'm probably older, a lot older probably than
no,
you are.
No, I don't think so.
But when we were growing up, you couldn't come here. The theater wasn't accessible to us. I mean, I didn't even come down to Chinatown. I came through here on a bus, but I didn't really ever come into this area. And so during my year as Miss Universe, it was 96, 97, you know, they started to kick off the cobwebs and do all of the renovations. I came back in 98 for a HIF, and I walked in here and it was like I was on another planet. I mean, this place was just transformed and transcends any other experience I've ever had in any theater in Hawaii, really. And so the spirit of this place is just sort of amazing. And it just, I can't imagine 100 years ago, you know, people sitting here in their holomus and the kukuinuts and all of, you know, the accoutrement and watching the biggest shows of the time. I mean, it's just kind of like that sort of pico to be able to connect to that is really sort of special.
Yeah, definitely. And we want to remind people that there's so much to see and do here at the theater. And there's magical shows, there's comedies, there's obviously Hawaiian music and, you know, headliners coming in from the mainland. But I think we could have, Brooke, come here way back when. There's a lot of very affordable shows here.
Of course,
so it's not out of the realm of anybody's possibility to come.
Right.
And don't be scared off by the beauty and the magnificence
right.
of this
true.
Place. We want everyone to come in and feel that this is their
right.
home as well.
Right. I mean, that's really important that, you know, there's all the big fancy acts, but Hawaii Symphony is here. You know, the Youth Symphony is here. Your daughter performed here. You know, there's a lot of, there's definitely a grounding in the community. Tell us a little bit about this. I heard some wonderful things about the Pride Parade that happened because, you know, that was a big deal through Waikiki. But you guys showed up and showed out for Hawaii Pride. You were in charge of the float?
You know, it was only a few. I was taking a break after our huge centennial soiree, right, which was wonderful. But then I get a call. I was like, okay, Greg, I'm not going to see you for a while. And then a few weeks later, they're like, oh, we decided, you know, to have a float. And can you do it for us? And so we had 18 days.
Wow.
From concept to being in Pride.
Right.
And then we were the finale float. And so immediately when they asked me, the first thing that came to my mind as an interior designer, mm-hmm, you know, it's like, okay, a Hawaii theater float, what are we gonna do?
Right.
We gotta have the Hawaii theater. So I designed a floating Hawaii theater.
Wow.
With a stage and lights and an audience. And we actually took some of the Hawaii theater seats and put it on the back of the truck. And that was our theater. It was pretty fun and
that's
fabulous.
That's insane.
Yeah.
In 18 days, no
In
less.
In 18 days.
Wow. Okay, well, you win. Well, thank you so much for all that you do. I mean, I know it's, you know, the board of directors and being behind the scenes making this whole place sort of tick. It's really an unsung hero type of job. So thanks again for coming on the show.
Thank you, Brooke. Appreciate it.
Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Well, that's our show for today, Hawaii. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did here at the beautiful Hawaii Theater. Congratulations to all of them for 100 years of arts here in Hawaii. Thank you to Sarah Richards for all of the wonderful work she's done over the years to help bring her back to life here at Hawaii Theater. To Gregory Dunn and the hard work that he does day in, day out to make sure that the community arts are served here, as well as all the wonderful acts that they bring in. And of course, my Pearl City girl, Cathy Lee, for coming on the show and all of the wonderful things they've done to help celebrate 100 years here at Hawaii Theater, from doing the Pride Parade and their wonderful gala. Remember, the shows are going to go on for a whole year from 2022 into 2023. So come check out some of the centennial events that will be going on here at Hawaii Theater. Remember to support the arts if you can, because it's been a very long process during the pandemic to be able to keep the arts alive and well here in Hawaii'i, and no one has done it better than here at Hawaii Theater. So if you are feeling generous and you do want to give back, make sure you check out their website and help us keep Hawaii Theater going into the next 100 years. I'll see all of you next week.